F-35 could soon be equipped with a new anti-ship missile. The U.S. Navy is exploring the acquisition of an economically efficient and compact air-launched standoff anti-ship weapon. Specific variants of the F-35 stealth fighter will have the capability to internally carry 4 of these weapons. The Naval Air Systems Command issued a contracting notice on February 2nd for what is currently identified as the Multi-Mission Affordable Capacity Effector Weapon System, or MACE. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the F-35 could become a warship buster with a potential new missile in its arsenal. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The MACE notice states, "The USN, U.S. Navy, requires the rapid development, prototyping, and fielding of an air-launched weapon with adequate standoff ranges to provide desired lethality without exposing manned platforms to significant survivability risks and jeopardizing mission effectiveness. So, Naval Air Systems Command is conducting market research to determine if there are any responsible sources that have the capability, experience, and facilities required to support the rapid development, maturation, integration, prototyping, test, qualification, and initial fielding of prototype units in support of this effort." Nav Air has publicly specified the requirements for MACE, including a range equivalent to the AGM-158C-1.1 long-range anti-ship missile (LRASM) when launched from an aircraft traveling at Mach 0.8 at an altitude of 30,000 feet above sea level. While the exact maximum range of the LRASM is classified, publicly available information suggests similarity with the AGM-158 Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile (JASSM) Land Attack Cruise Missile, which has a range of around 300 miles, or 483 kilometers. It's worth noting that LRASM is essentially an anti-ship variant of JASSM. The U.S. Navy additionally desires MACE to include a guidance system capable of detecting and targeting moving surface combatants and surface targets, along with a 75-pound or 34-kilogram warhead. The MACE weapon must be compatible with the FA-18 E&F Super Hornets as the designated launch platforms. Additionally, NAVAIR's specifications indicate missiles should be designed from the beginning so that 4 of these weapons can be accommodated within the internal bays of F-35A or F-35C joint strike fighters. F-35B, short takeoff and vertical landing variant, has a smaller bay and is most likely to be excluded or carry only 2 of these. In this context, it's to be noted that LRASM and JASSM are too big to be carried internally by any version of the joint strike fighter. The U.S. Navy's goal is for each MACE to cost less than $300,000, and for the manufacturer to be able to make at least 500 of them a year. For comparison, LRASMs and their variants cost around $3 million apiece, and the maximum annual production rate is 120 missiles. As per NAVAIR, MACE will achieve increased range at lower costs by leveraging investments by the Department of Defense (DOD), Science and Technology Enterprise, and industry partners to integrate a high-maturity propulsion system with proven payloads that are designed with a high-quantity production mindset. The notice also requested an open architecture design to expedite the development of future upgrades and new variants. F-35, being a fifth-generation fighter, is developed from the ground up to be stealthy. Its external structure is designed to deflect signals away from the emitting radar, which makes it hard to detect or track. This is done by having no sharp edges or protruding elements and having a smooth external curvature. Also, it has a coating of RAM, radar-absorbing material, that reduces the number of signals getting reflected. F-35 has the lowest radar cross-section, RCS, of all the jets, except the F-22 Raptor. Against X-band radars, it's stealthy from the front and rear. Against S-band radar, it's stealthy from the narrow front aspect. Against L-band radar, the limited reduction is achieved from direct front. Classified techniques have also been used to reduce the heat signature of F-35. This thermal profile management of the jet makes it difficult for infrared or IR homing missiles to target it. While the F-35 is capable of carrying weapons on its external weapons pylons under its wings, the ability to carry missiles internally would preserve its stealthy profile. According to the Pentagon's annual report released in October, China has expanded its fleet to over 370 ships and submarines, a significant increase from the 340 in 2023, solidifying its position as the world's largest navy in terms of numerical strength. While the U.S. Navy still remains the most potent naval force in terms of tonnage and capabilities, China is expanding rapidly. It's important that the U.S. builds its ability to take out enemy warships. F-35 is poised to take an important role in this regard. The stealth characteristic of the fighter can potentially enable it to penetrate even highly defended airspace and launch this missile. Conventional tactical jets, such as the FA-18E and F, will also be capable of carrying these in substantial quantities, which would result in increased striking power for individual aircraft per sortie. If the U.S. military-industrial complex, which has some very proficient players like Raytheon and Lockheed Martin, is able to deliver on this requirement, it could go a long way in preserving U.S. naval dominance. It's reported that some companies are already working on this kind of weapon. For example, Boeing's Powered Joint Direct Attack Munition, PJDAM, or its derivative could be one of the contenders. It remains to be seen how things will unfold.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.